They'd sold out or they'd compromised. I would have thought that the development of the music was almost inevitable.
It has to be, really. I mean, that's the whole point when we all started, all the bands at that particular point in time, The Clash, the Stranglers, all those different bands had separate sounds. None of them sounded alike, and they all adapted and changed in many ways. I think it was the next wave of punk music that got pigeonholed by the press, if you like, and they thought that, you know, it was just three chords and singing about being on the dole and all that, when in fact it never was. It was just being the love for the music itself, you know, the optimism and whatever, and the excitement generated by that time.
Has your attitude changed since the early days to what you're doing?
I don't really think so, you know. I mean, obviously some things do change, but we want to take risks all the time with music. I mean, it would have been easy to have done five albums, all of standard sort of punk songs, like New Rose or whatever, which is a good song, but if we'd done albums like that, it would have been a real cop-out, I think. You know, this way, we're keeping it exciting for us and everybody else, I hope. You know. It does, obviously, it sort of demands more on the people who listen to our music, because they don't know if the next album's going to change completely or what direction we're going to go in.
What difference do you think has the involvement of Bryn and Roman made from the original lineup when you set out, and indeed since the Captain left?
Well, obviously the band's gone through many changes, but we never really had a good bass player as such before. And I think Bryn is very good in as much as he makes Rat work harder. You know, he's more conscious of keeping time with the songs. Therefore, there's a nice steady backbeat to everything, a solid, rather than it getting too chaotic and the songs getting lost. And, of course, the speeds of the song, which are important. Because it's a lot harder with a song to stay or maintain an edge and not, you know, go a million miles an hour, to actually keep it back slightly, than it is just to go on 1, 2, 3, 4 and it's all very fast. And Roman, well, the emphasis of who writes the songs is basically on my shoulders and Roman's now, the guitarist. So that's also changed. Because, I mean, Captain wrote a lot when he was with the band. Brian James wrote the first album and most of the second album. So, yeah, there's a big difference there.
The single from earlier in 85, Grimly Fiendish, I believe, was, I think, was your highest chart placing. Does that make you feel any different? Were you pleased about that?
I was obviously pleased that it's in the charts, because it means a lot of discerning music lovers are playing our records. But, you know, it does make it worthwhile. I mean, we've been at it a fair time. 9 years is quite a bit, and when you actually see things happening like that, it does cheer you up a bit. I mean, we went through a very bad time where I think many other bands would have just called it a day and split up, but through, you know, sheer, I don't know, doggedness to what we do, we kept going, luckily.